I just finished doing my IBA tax return for the month of May. This is a process that I've talked about in the past. For those of you that are over 65 years old and you're living here in Ecuador, you're entitled to a portion of your, you're entitled to receiving a portion of your sales tax back as a rebate that you paid throughout the month. You get up to $107 per month back, but you have to file a return each month. It's an arduous process to go through, and I'm gonna show you how I did it right after this.
Hey! Oh, Rocket Chick. Roger. Hello there.
So it's a bit of a process. You have to hire an interpreter unless you can speak Spanish and go down to the SRI office here in Monte. It's right behind the mall. And go in there and tell them you want to start filing for your monthly rebate of your sales tax. They'll give you login credentials and give you a website you can go to. And you go home, log into this SRI website, create an account for yourself, set your password, all that good stuff. And then as you go out through the month and when you make purchases at any place, okay, that has a point of sale system, which is most restaurants and grocery stores and computer store, appliance store, wherever, always use your cedula, and then that transaction will get recorded with SRI. And when you log in each month to file this tax return, you'll go through the process that you're going to see me do here in just a minute. You will see all of these transactions, and you'll have to do a little bit of legwork here to document that the transactions are in fact yours and so forth. After you're done and when you submit it, then you'll have they'll automatically make a deposit to your bank account. I know that some of you are going to ask me, well, what if my bank account's in the United States? I can't answer for that. I think it's going to have to be a local bank account here. So I always encourage everybody, you know, if you come here and you invest in CDs, you'll have a bank account at JEP or whatever credit union you choose to go with, you know, and they will just automatically do a direct deposit of your refund to you each month. So here's the process. I know it's going to be a little confusing maybe, but when you get here and you want to go through this, give me a call. I'll come out and show you how. You have to have a computer, obviously, a laptop or something, so you can get on their site and go through this process, and I will help you, okay? So here it is. Hope you enjoy. If you have any questions, let me know.
Okay, so let's get started. I will put a link in the description to the SRI website. This is what the front page looks like. You'll get this link when you go to their office and register for the first time. You're going to have to go in there, take your cedula with you, and I would also recommend that you have an interpreter with you. Go in there and tell them you want to start applying for your VAT refund, monthly refund. They will give you your login credentials, and then you'll have to go home, log into this website, change your password, and then you're good to go. Once you've launched the website and you are directed to this main menu page, you will notice the choices that you have on the left side of the screen. And of course, the main choice you are interested in is the refunds, tax refunds that you see in the brackets here. Using your mouse, select the option refunds, tax refunds, then choose VAT refunds, seniors. This will take you to this login page. Once you've logged in here, you have the option to make it remember you the next time, and you won't need to enter credentials the next time you log in. Your credentials will just be automatically there. Once you log in, you're taken to this page. This is where you start your return process. Click on the Start Return Process button. The rest of this is pretty self-explanatory. You just click on the links, you know, accept and go to the next page. Just keep following the links. Select, press on select to go to the next page. Select Enter Electronic Invoices. Pick the year. Pick the month. Like in this case, I'll pick May, because that was last month. I always do last month's return when I'm doing these. Then select search. So here's where it starts getting interesting. You get a page, looks like a ledger page. You get to see all the activity for the month, all right? Each transaction was a transaction that was uploaded to SRI from the vendor. And if you look at this first line here, you'll see that Cordova Balcazar, and the amount is 0.71, so 71 cents. That's the amount of VAT tax that I paid on this transaction. And what you had to do is enter that in that little square that the arrow is pointing to here. If you don't know what it's about, and you need to kind of know what these transactions are about, because you'll see here in a minute that you'll have to enter a classification for each transaction. You can always click on the PDF like here. Depending on how quick your computer is, that'll open up a PDF page like you see here. So now you get to try to figure out what this invoice means, because everything's going to be in Spanish. But for those of you that can read Spanish, like I partially can, you can figure it out, okay? You can also look at the IBA tax amount like you see here at the arrow at the bottom and kind of, you know, make the association, and you'll figure it out. You'll know what it's for when you see it. Okay, so pay attention here now. Pay real close attention, because I'm only going to go over this once, all right? And if somebody calls me and says, Don, I don't understand how to do that, and I have to explain this again, then I'm going to say you didn't pay attention. So anyway, look at the four columns that I have in the square box. There's VAT amount, VAT requested, expense type, and select. Now, obviously, select means you're going to put a check mark in each one of those boxes. You can sit here and go all the way down that page if you want to and put a check mark in each one of those boxes. You can do it however you want to do it. The important thing here that I want you to really pay attention to is, like, on this very first transaction that's on the line one, is you see that the VAT amount is 0.71. But look what I put in the box and VAT requested. I put in 0.71. And I didn't think, you know, that you'll notice that there's no period in there. If you look at that, the VAT requested that I put in there, you'll see I put in 0.71, okay? For some reason, I couldn't do 0.71, because that's what I thought I had to do. I thought I had to do, that's 71 cents. So I said, okay, 0.71. But that's not the way they want it. You have to put it exactly the way it's written in the VAT amount column. If it's 0.71, then in the VAT requested box, you have to type in 0.71. Okay, you got it? You got to do it exactly the way they do it. Look in the third line there, 0.02. That's for 2 cents. If you just put 0.02 or 0.2, it's going to fail, and you have to come back and correct it. The third column, obviously, is the expense type. It's a pull down. There's, you know, a lot of the stuff that you'll never use. It's mostly feeding, housing, or other. And so, I mean, and most of mine are feeding anyway. And then, of course, you have to check the select box. Okay? So the important thing to remember, the amount that you put in has to be exactly the way it's written in the VAT amount. And that's what you type in the VAT requested. And if you do it exactly the way it's written by them, you won't have any trouble. Okay, so once you've got everything entered, you've entered all your, you filled in all these, the main thing is the three items, the three columns, you put in the amount, you classified it, and you checked it. You proceed to the next page, you keep on going until you get every page done. And then as you see in the lower left-hand corner here, process selected invoices. That'll be your next step. But now, oh my God, what if you get this? Return by internet, seen errors. There are errors. It is not possible to continue with the loading of information. You can. This is what happens when you don't enter the amounts correctly. VAT value requested greater than the invoice. Pretty self-explanatory. Try again. So then you have to go back and make sure that it's 0.02 or 0.071. or 0.71, you know, you have to write it exactly the way they specified it in the invoice, or you're going to get this error. Once you correct all of those, then you can resubmit it again, and hopefully you won't get this page again. So once you corrected all your entries, come back and try it again. Process selected invoices, and you'll be good to go. But now, what if you get this error? There are errors. It is not possible to continue with the loading of information. VAT value requested greater than the maximum allowed. See, year 2023, month 5. So what they're telling you here is that you exceeded the maximum amount of your refund for the month. You're only allowed $107 per month. So you had to go back and remove some entries from your invoices until you get the greater or the total amount under $107. So as you can see here, my total was $113.17. I had to get this down to under 107 or less. So I had to go back, okay, and remove something. So I went back and corrected mine. I removed two or three small entries and I got it down to 105.77. That's good enough for me. I'm sure that I probably could have nitpicked through these invoices and found a penny here and a penny there and got it to exactly 107 or close to it, but this is enough for me. So I corrected it and I'm ready to submit now. So there it is. I've completed everything. I've done it correctly. All my invoices are entered correctly and I'm ready to submit. And all you have to do is click Save Selection Made and you're done. That's all there is to it.
That's it. See how easy that was? If you like this channel, please subscribe if you want to. If you like this video, smash that thumbs up button. If you didn't like it, bite me. And I'll see that with peace and love. I'll see you on the next one. Ciao, ciao.